This episode of DNews is brought to you by LG G3. Researchers have found a way to make glass tubes a tenth the thickness of your hair send cat videos around the world. Better. They found a way to do all that, but better. Hi, Julian here for DNews. Your smartphone is super cool. You've got all the DNews you could possibly want anywhere. But you're not really totally wireless. You're within a few miles of a cell phone tower, but that tower may be hundreds of miles from the servers with all that juicy knowledge stored. So, how do you connect the two? Why, with laser beams, of course. Let's begin at the beginning, which is all the way back in the 1840s when Swiss physicist Daniel Colodon noticed he could shine a light in one end of a water pipe and it would come out the other side. 170 years later, modern optic fibers are basically the same thing, but they use optically pure glass and are 9,000ths of a millimeter thick instead. You may be wondering, how does light travel inside water or glass without just bouncing out and being lost? Well, the answer is it all has to do with the angle the light is shown in. If the light is hitting the walls of the glass at a shallow angle, less than 42 degrees, it'll experience total internal reflection and bounce back and forth down the glass. This property of light is the same reason you can look out over a lake and see a beautiful reflection, but when you look straight down, you can see into the water. To make sure none of that light does leak out, the optical glass is encased in a cladding with a higher refraction index that can bend the light back into the glass. Then that's put in a buffer coating, and each of these fibers can carry the equivalent data of 10 million phone calls, and hundreds of thousands are bundled together and stuffed into a jacket to make a fiber optic cable. Because of them, you can send a beam of light to the other side of the planet in a seventh of a second. Now, being able to shoot light through a glass tube to China is all well and good, but you still need a way to send information, and that is where modulation comes in. Modulation is when you vary some property of a wave to encode information. Then when it gets to the destination, it's demodulated to separate the carrier from the message. You've been dealing with it a lot and you might not even know it. FM radio uses frequency modulation, which is when a wave's length is altered. AM is when a wave's amplitude is changed, and the modem in your house is short for modulator, demodulator. In fiber optics, there's a lot of ways to modulate a beam and send information. There's AM, sine wave FM, square wave FM, pulse frequency modulation, which is basically turning the beam on and off so it can be interpreted as a series of ones and zeros. And all of these methods need costly external modulators, which are costly and inefficient. But Dr. Radin Slavik, who is a research fellow at Optoelectronic Research Center and probable James Bond nemesis, has improved another method. They've devised a way to adjust the current of the laser beams so they can have better control of the optical field and send more information. Actually, the words Dr. Radin Slavik used were exquisite control over the optical field generated directly from a current-modulated semiconductor laser. Tell me he is not a Bond villain. There was another awesome breakthrough in sending wireless signals a few months ago. I talk about that and a bit more about fiber optics over here. If you know of some interesting tech in the pipeline and want us to cover it, let us know in the comments, and I'll see you next time on DNews. This episode of DNews is brought to you by LG G3.